Dignitaries, all my dear friends. First of all, I extend my heartfelt congratulations to the organizers and also my sincere gratitude for inviting me for this session. Let me share few medical aspects related to flood and disaster and the consequences. Health effects in flood disaster. It is closely connected directly through contact with flood waters, indirectly from damage to the infrastructure, ecosystem, food and water supplies, or social support systems. They can be immediate effects, or it can appear after days, weeks, or months after flood has receded. Flood-related deaths. It can be seen 2/3 from drowning and 1/3 from physical trauma, heart attack, electrocution, carbon monoxide and such events. The vulnerable group associated with health, disease and the flood are children, pregnant women, people with chronic illnesses, people who rely on home care, elderly persons, people with physical, mental, sensory and other cognitive impairments, tourists who are not familiar to the event, homeless people, people from poor socio-economic conditions, socially isolated persons. Health impacts in flood situation increases the morbidity of disease conditions and the mortality associated with the disease conditions, and there is an increased demand for health system during this time. Immediate death can happen from seeing the disaster. People can get heart attack, and especially those who are associated with cardiac problems. Drowning from walking or driving through the flood areas, injury from contact with debris, submerged objects in the floodwaters, falling into hidden manholes, trying to move possessions during flood, building collapse and damage, electrocution and chemical poisoning, contamination from carbon monoxide poisoning and other associated with the generators and pumping and dehumidifying things. Then infections seen during the flood situation are due to poor sanitation. There can be diarrheal diseases, acute respiratory infection, influenza, such situation may be associated with overcrowding. People go into camps in 2,000, 4,000, 6,000 people, and there also can have diarrheal diseases, acute infections like pneumonia, associated with pneumonia, influenza, hepatitis, different kind of jaundice. Vector-borne diseases, usually mosquito-borne, that is dengue, chikungunya, malaria, etc. Rodent-borne, like associated with rat. Very commonly seen main fatal diseases, leptospirosis, tetanus, rabies, etc. Certain conditions associated with the psychological aspects, like people get depressive, then stress associated with the long term, maybe short term or long term, due to the loss of property, loss of dear ones, seeing the disaster situation as such, negative health effects from linked with overcrowding and natural nutritional stress factors. The most common fatal disease associated with flooding is leptospirosis. Actually, people can lose their life due to leptospirosis. The culprit individual is the rat itself. Rat eats the food items, and its excreta is the thing. It's a rodent's excreta is a contaminant. Children or adult, whoever, can get the excreta. Through excreta, the organism come into the person's body. So that picture you can see, splash into the conjunctiva or swallow the organism as such. It is bacteria, the contaminated food items, or can be from the cuts, wounds, whatever have in the body we have exposed to the organism. Then people in the flood situation, we walk in the flood waters or in the contaminated things around the living condition, living areas, then organism come into the person's body, not body, but this rodent's body, and then from the rodent only we will get the infection. Once the infection you we get, fever is the first one, then fatigue, nausea, loss of appetite, dark urine, vomiting, jaundice, stomach pain. These are the common symptoms associated with leptospirosis. Next. Usually we get end organ problems like lung, liver, kidney, brain. These are the main organs affected by this organism, and people may succumb to the disease. Next one is the one, dengue fever, which is commonly seen. Even that presents as fever, rash, muscle and severe body pain. And then the blood counts. We usually understand this is a viral fever. The other one was a bacterial infection. This is viral fever. This we will identify from now. The CAR test is available for early detection. But the blood count is the one goes down very drastically. Platelet count and the WBC count goes down. The person will get susceptible to the bacterial infection, and also blood loss due to bleeding from all the different areas, and renal failure, kidney failure, lung infection, and again the encephalopathy, coma, such situations, and people can lose their life. Next common disease is a typhoid fever, again due to contaminated water and food items. The one is snake bite. The difficult situation is the approach to the hospital and the medical assistance is maybe delayed due to flood situation, and people can succumb to the bite. Risk posed by corpse. Dead body usually do not give epidemics, because the organism cannot live in the dead body more than 6 hours, it seems. The thing happens due to dead body is exposure to bloodborne viruses, then tuberculosis and gastrointestinal infection from the spread from the fecus of the dead person or animals. So hence, prevention is better than cure. What are the preventive measures? Next. Avoid disease that spread through waters, first of all. Avoid eating raw food items. Store water in clean container. Wash hands properly. Drink only filtered and boiled water. Avoid ice cubes. Avoid consuming beverage, especially in the open areas. Next. Water source. For water source and the treatment procedures, disinfection, storage, etc., can consist of packaged water, tanker water, direct use of alternative water, boiled water. Then chlorination of the water, very important. Drinking water can become disinfected easily with the chlorination, highly effective against nearly all the waterborne pathogens. At doses very few milligram per liter, the contact time can within 30 minutes, more than 99% of the organism can be destroyed. Food, personal hygiene, stagnant water to be removed, and don't allow the children to play in the stagnant waters. Clean up the surroundings, destroy mosquitoes, maybe again bleaching powder is the best thing. Contaminated food avoid. Consult a doctor as soon as any person get, especially fever and such infected cases, and detect the problem at the earliest. Next one is the vaccination and prevention. Vaccines are hepatitis A and B. Tetanus toxoid if required, there is injury. Typhoid vaccine if epidemics or anything. Tablet doxycycline for the prevention every week 200 mg for the adult and the children 100 mg. Then, when we come to the practical points, as for the health, how can we sustain the health for the future? Because these are the things I told may happen within early stages. The next stages are the one people get, especially infections. And next one is a stressful condition. Mentally they are depressed. Another one is when they get sickness and then huge amount of money they need, and at the same time they don't have the money. So such situations, what are the plans are? We can plan for medical camps, maybe weekly, monthly, like that. Identify the persons, especially those who are poor and vulnerable people. And then we can form certain things like how to plan for the financial support. Maybe we can include them in Medicaid facilities, or plan for support to the vulnerable and very weak people by different organizations when they are getting admitted to hospitals, to provide them support such situations. And then maybe counseling sessions and follow-up of these people was required, maybe for the future strengthening of the life and the situation. So thank you once again, and for all the best for the next sessions. I conclude.